Listen, I need everyone to go and register for the Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference next year. The dates are February 22nd to the 25th. The theme for next year is Holy Rage, Holy Hope, Radical Reimagination for Transforming Communities. Listen, I need all of y'all to register and be there. It's going to be virtual, but it's still going to be powerful. Now more than ever, we need to meet. We need to learn. We need to pray. We need to strategize. Register for the conference. See you there.
Our annual conference experience is never complete without our beloved seminarians. So we just wanted to remind you that the 2021 Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference is offered as a course intensive. And so many of our seminaries from across the country offer credit for conference participation. Reverend Dr. Valerie Bridgman, who is the Dean at Methodist Theological Seminary, and Reverend Dr. Ebony Marshall Terman, who is an assistant professor at Yale Divinity School, will be our 2021 conference co-deans. If you are an active seminarian, you will want to have the 2021 Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference on your spring course schedule. Register today at sdpconference.info, and you will also receive 10% off the registration cost. Thank you so much, and we look forward to welcoming you this winter. Amen. Good morning, and welcome to the Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference Service of Daily Prayer and Song. Today is Monday, November 23rd, and whether you are on Facebook, on YouTube, or any other social media outlet, we are so thankful that you're with us this morning. We also wanted to invite you to look at our website at sdbconference.info, and we'd also like to invite you to receive text message updates from the Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference, and you can do so by texting the letters SDPC to the number 84576. We promise your information is safe with us. And if you know anyone who does not have access to the internet, please let them know that they can listen to this service today at noon and 8:30 p.m. Central Standard Time by dialing the number 909-318-7011. Thank you so much. And now to our host, Reverend Mark Thompson.
Thank you, Reverend Webb. Good morning, all. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out. As shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries and will bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel by the watercourses and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pleasure. There shall they lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak. But the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Lord, once again, we invoke your presence for our proctor prayer-demic, asking you to seek out the lost, to bring back the strayed, to bind up the injured, to strengthen the weak, Lord, and to serve those who are against us, the fat and the strong, with justice. Please heal the sick and the brokenhearted. Please comfort those who've lost loved ones. Please provide for the poor, the hungry, and the homeless. Release the incarcerated and protect those on the front line of the pandemic. And please protect those in the line of fire, dear Lord, in the line of fire of the police demic, and the pistoldemic of gun violence that is still rampant in our communities. Comfort those and heal those who have been injured by gun violence, especially on this weekend. We gather to pray for the power to overcome all of these plagues. We gather to pray for the power to change the socioeconomic and political conditions that have left generations so vulnerable, that though many have died, yet shall they live on through us and our work. Bless our prayer warrior and minister of music this morning. Bless this Proctor Conference. And please dispatch our ancestors to watch over us and provide us their shoulders and their eternal vigilance, which to emulate. It is in their sacred names and in the righteous and powerful name of Jesus, the Black Christ, we do pray. And the people of God said, Ashe and Amen. God bless you and good morning on this Monday morning as we begin another week, a week of Thanksgiving, a week for us to give thanks, but also to remember the popular image of Thanksgiving is not true. And we lift up our indigenous people, our indigenous sisters and brothers throughout this entire week. We greet you, as always, in an indigenous language to our people from South Africa, the Zulu language, Sawubonani, which means we see you, we value you, we respect you, all of you, each and every one of you, all of you are important to us. And most of all, each and every one of you do matter. Our prayer warrior this morning received a Bachelor of Arts from Grinnell College and a Master of Divinity degree from the University of Chicago Divinity School. He is a candidate for the Doctor of Philosophy degree in theology at the University of Chicago, where his research interests focus on developing a theology of liberation for the situation of mass incarceration in the United States. He is currently the 11th senior pastor of the First Baptist Church, Highland Avenue in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Immediately following our ministry of music this morning, and we welcome back as always, Opal Staples. The next voice you will hear will be our prayer warrior, the Reverend Paul Robeson, the Reverend Paul Robeson, amen, Ford. Draw near and hear ye him, amen.
We are grateful at Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference, and in the spirit of the holiday that we are coming upon, we don't want to focus on what they give us. We just want to focus on our gratitude. We're still here. We still are awake. We're breathing. And as long as we are doing that, we will be found here praying and worshiping. Oh, Lord, just want to tell you that we're grateful. I am grateful for the things that you have done. Yes, I'm grateful for the victories we've won. I could go on and on, oh, and on about your works. Because I'm grateful, grateful, so grateful just to praise you, Lord. Flowing from my heart, my God, so many issues of my heart is gratefulness.
God, I am grateful for the victories we've won. I could go on and on and on and on and on and on about your works. I'm grateful, so grateful just to praise you, Lord. Oh, flowing from my heart, oh God, are the issues of my heart. Oh, it's gratefulness. Oh my, I'm grateful.
Here's my favorite part. It just repeats.
Grateful, 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 my God. Grateful, grateful. Whew. Gratefulness. Grateful, grateful, grateful. I'm grateful. So very grateful, God. Grateful. Gratefulness. Grateful, 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 grateful. Flowing from my heart, flowing from my, flowing from my heart, God, are the issues of my heart, flowing from my. Gratefulness.
Oh God, how grateful we indeed are. Grateful for this day. Oh Lord, that you woke us up and started us on our way, oh Lord. Grateful for a reasonable portion of life, health, and strength as we start out this week. When we are inclined to focus our hearts, our minds, our spirits on that for which we ought be thankful, those good and perfect gifts that come from you, the Father of lights, that come down from heaven and come into this world and interject into our situations in spite of all of the circumstances that surround us, oh God, that would seek to subdue us, O Lord. We come to you this morning grateful. We come to you this morning thankful. We come to you this morning giving you honor and glory, for you are, always have been, and remain the only one who is indeed worthy of it all. Oh God, we come to you this morning with a prayer that has been on many of our hearts throughout this almost entire year. A prayer for healing and for help and for hope, oh God. We need healing, oh Lord, for the hundreds of thousands, millions of victims of this plague and this pestilence all around this world. Oh God, we're not just praying selfishly for people in America, but for everyone all over this world, oh God, who has been afflicted, oh God, by this sickness, even as we look to the promise of a vaccine. We know, oh Lord, that the issues of equity will impact how that vaccine gets to our people. And so, oh God, we need you to come in a way of healing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we double up on what has already been lifted before you in praying for the victims of gun violence, whether it be at the hands of the community or at the hands of the police. Oh Lord, the injuries are still the same and need your touch, oh God, and we pray for their healing in the physical, but also in the mental and the emotional and the spiritual from the traumatic, oh God. We pray, oh Lord, for healing for hardened hearts, oh God, and sick spirits, oh Lord, that divide us and separate us during these tumultuous times, oh God, during this season of unrest and reckoning, oh Lord. We need, oh God, the strength and the collective understanding to turn from our wicked ways, oh God, and look to you that you would heal the land, oh God. But we ask as well, oh Lord, for help, oh God, help as we struggle, oh Lord, struggle against the injustice that continues, oh God, to afflict us. Oh God, help, oh Lord, as we seek to endure these challenges, oh God. Help, oh Lord, as we muddle through this transition that is shrouded in lies, oh God, in the shadow of deception, the darkness of deception, oh God. We need your help, oh Lord, as we struggle day by day, oh Lord, and as the struggle seeks to exasperate our souls, oh God, help us to overcome by the power of your Holy Spirit, oh Lord. Help us, oh God, that the work of these hands, oh God, you would find favor on them, oh Lord, and they would manufacture a change, manufacture righteousness, manufacture your uplifting glory in this world, oh God. We ask finally, oh Lord, for hope, oh God, that you would keep hope alive in our hearts, oh Lord, because the struggle to fight against hopelessness is real, oh Lord. As we look at our phones and see the headlines that can cause us such dismay, as we follow day by day, oh God, this occupant's refusal to accept the reality of what has happened, oh God, and to manufacture victory out of defeat, oh Lord, it can seem overwhelming. Oh God, but many have told us before that we must keep hope alive, and we continue to believe that faith is the substance of things hoped for, oh God, and the evidence of things not seen, oh Lord. And so you know what we hope for, and we just ask, oh God, that you would keep that hope alive in our hearts. As Advent comes and approaches, oh God, it comes with so much promise in a time of so much peril, and perhaps now more than ever before, we need to believe in the miracle of Advent, in the miracle of this event, the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, under circumstances of oppression, under circumstances, oh God, of want, under circumstances of colonialism, oh Lord, in a manger, oh God, because there was no vacancy, oh Lord, at the inn, under circumstances of scandal, oh God, because of what the world expected for his mother, and then what you did instead, oh God. We need to believe in that promise. We need to believe in that miracle. as we look towards an end to this pandemic, oh God, as we look towards the consummation, oh Lord, of justice for your people who have been underfoot for so long and yet pressing on and making our way day by day. Oh God, we ask you to nurture hope in our hearts, that it would be vital and vibrant and alive this day, O Lord, but each and every day. O God, we pray for Reverend Warnock. We pray for John Ossoff. We pray for Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. We pray for all of those, O Lord, who will now step into leadership, O God, that they would let you to lead them. Oh God, we pray, oh Lord, for all of those who should have been on this call this morning, but who did not make it, oh God, that you would reach them where they are, oh God. We pray for all of the families under the sound of my voice today, oh God, that you would touch them each in their situations, oh God, each in the ways that they need healing, each in the ways that they need help, each in the ways, oh God, that they are struggling to sustain and maintain hope. Oh Lord, you are our creator, our sustainer, and redeemer. And we believe that you are redeeming, sustaining, and even creating us still, oh God. And so we are thankful and we are grateful on this morning. You hear and know the issues that are flowing from our hearts. Speak to them, Lord, right now in the way that only you can. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, with confidence and with power, we lift this prayer. Amen.
We thank God that this is going to be a lovely day. We're grateful. It's all right to bob your head after prayer. When I wake up in the morning, Lord, and the sunlight hurts my eyes. When something without warning, Lord, weighs heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Right where you at, just raise your hand and say, thank you, God. For a lovely day, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now when the day that lies ahead of me seems impossible to face, yeah. And when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way, Lord, then I look at you and I know it's I know it's gonna be a lovely day, yeah. A lovely day,
lovely day.
I'm grateful. The day will be what you make it. In everything, giving thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you and concerning me and concerning us. So after a word of prayer and a petition to God, in proof that we believe that he's already done what he said he would do, we ought to rejoice.
Then I look at you and I know that it's all right with me. It is well with my soul, yeah. Just one look at you and I know it's gonna
said it's gonna be one, yeah. I do believe it will be a lovely day. Got to be a lovely day. Ooh, yeah. A lovely day, a lovely day, a lovely day, a lovely day, a lovely day. It will be a lovely, lovely, yeah, day. A lovely, ooh, yeah. Lovely day, yeah. I really do believe it will be, ooh, be, ooh, be, ooh, a lovely day. Yeah, said it's gonna be one, yeah. Take it away, Reverend Mark, a lovely day.
Amen, 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 amen. Lovely day indeed. Thank you, Opal. Thank you, Reverend Paul Robeson, for it. Amen. Folks, when you have a minute, please stop by our website, sdpconference.info. Please support our work. And also you can stop by Givelify and find Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference there too. Your donations support the work for justice and the vision of the Samuel DeWitt Proctor Conference. We are so blessed and so grateful, amen, to be in community with you. If all hearts and minds are clear. Lord, we thank you today for our wonderful service. We thank you for our prayer warrior, the Reverend Paul Robeson, for today. And we thank you for our minister of music, Opal Staples, today, especially for lifting up our ancestor, Bill Withers. God bless him. We know he is with you. Now to you who are able to keep us from falling at all times, but especially now amidst this pestilence and the police, Rona, and racism, and all of the things that we are facing. And to make us to stand healed from illness, grief, discrimination, intimidation, fear, all of these things in the presence of your glory with rejoicing. To you, our only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ, our Lord, before all time, right now and forevermore. When the day that lies ahead of us seems impossible to face, when someone else instead of us always seems to know the way, Lord, we look to you every morning, and the world's all right with us just looking toward you, and we know it's going to be a lovely day. And the people of God said, Ashe and amen. Yes, sisters and brothers, do please continue to pray and do please have a lovely day. We'll see you tomorrow morning. God bless you.